Here's Bison inspecting the frame that my husband Brian made for me from some scrap wood. The measurements are 12 by 36. And the front of the frame is this cool kind of chipped wood. So that is my frame, and unlike other weaving projects, I'm not going to put a bunch of nails in there, I'm not going to measure it out, I'm just going to grab a magic tool that I'll show you shortly. What do you think, Bice? Weaving with cats. This is the art yarn and the staple gun that I'll be using to warp my loom. I'm going to warp it the long way. So I've brought the yarn back and forth and back and forth and back and forth and kept it really loose because I'm going to be stapling it up here.
You help it?
So now I'm going through the creative process of trying to figure out what yarn to use as my weft. I was thinking about using this yarn, but I was afraid that it would turn the whole thing too green, and it would also, I really want all of the texture here to be the main focus. So this obviously would take away from that, as would this, as would this. So what I've decided to use is a mohair thread, which I've already spun into this yarn. So this mohair thread is also part of the yarn, so it goes together, and that way it will stay translucent and the texture of the art yarn that's the warp will be the focus of the piece. So now I'm just rolling a whole lot of this and preparing to weave it in there. And staple that. You may want to tie it in a knot as well, and we'll go ahead and bring it over and under all of these strands. It might help if you bring out some strings so that you don't end up fighting where you turn the corner. So over, under, over, under, over, under, over, under, over, under, and pull it. And under, over, under, over, under, over, under, over. And on she goes. So I'll go ahead and do the rest of that and then show you what that looks like when it's done. So here's the beginning of the piece, and I've woven back and forth that really fine mohair thread and I kept it spaced about an inch, but I didn't worry about perfection. And you want to make sure that it doesn't get too tight on the edges, or else you'll end up with buckling. So keep it all really loose. And we'll flip it over. What I'll do is I'll put a staple here and tie a knot, and then flip it over and show you the finished product. So I've got a little art yarn up top left over, and I don't know if I'm going to hang it from that or take that off or just nail it to the wall, but here's an idea of what it will look like once it's hanging on a wall. And I just have it kind of propped up right now. But that is a fun and easy way to weave with art yarn if you don't have a loom, but if you have a staple gun and some thin thread and one skein of art yarn. And you can do a project with this with 20 yards or even less, depending on the frame that you use. So thanks for watching and have fun weaving.